Hi everyone, so this is my first video and we are going to see something mathematical about electrical engineering. So today we are going to see about root mean square, that is RMS value. So here so we know that we have a sine wave in AC. Usually the sine wave will be represented in RMS value. For example, in India, 230 volt supply, we mention it with 50 hertz. Not only in India, in many places it is similar. And here we have a sine wave. How to represent that in a RMS value? Actually, as a waveform, it's a peak value. So it will be around 230 volt multiplied by square root of 2. That means it will be around 321 volt something. So this voltage is like the peak value of the sine wave. It's not the RMS. RMS means we need a single value. That means throughout it will be a constant. So this line is RMS and this peak is peak. So how to get this RMS? Usually what we will do with the peak value, we will divide it by square root of 2. As I have done, 230 multiplied by square root of 2 to get the peak value. The same way with the peak value, we will get the RMS by dividing it by square root of 2. So here you will be getting a 230 volt, but how this square root comes? So if you consider this example, in this itself we'll see, I am taking this as a peak 1 volt, or let it be 230, no problem, 230 volt, and that is a RMS value, not the peak. The peak value of 321, let it be. So the sine wave will be like V is equal to Vm sine omega t. This is the equation we use in all the formulas like for sine wave. So here if you see, the Vm is nothing but our peak value. It is 321 multiplied by sine omega t. Here omega is nothing but 2 pi f. The f is the frequency, so we already know our working frequency in India and in many countries it is 50 hertz. So 2 into pi into 50 is my omega. So now I am going to use the formula V equal to Vm sine 2 into pi into 50 multiplied by t. This t is the real time. That means it can be from start from 0. If you switch on the switch, it starts from 0 and it goes till infinity whenever you are going to switch it off. It will be in seconds or milliseconds or microseconds, however it is. How much time you are going to turn on the switch, it depends on that. So according to the 50 hertz, if you want to know for one cycle till here, for 50 hertz, it will be 1 divided by f, where you will get 1, sorry, that is nothing but t. So 1 by f is nothing but 1 by 50, which is equal to t. 1 by 50 is 0.02 seconds. So we are going to see one particular cycle and we are going to analyze how we get that square root of 2. So here we have considered this equation. Let us use this equation and we substitute. All the values are known because Vm is also here, 321, and the t value is going to be substituted. So how we are going to do the substitution of t is, it is going to be from 0 to 0.02. That is like we are going to take it like in an Excel sheet so that it will be easy for us to make this curve and the analysis. So we are going to take like 0 as the initial condition, 0 plus, I am taking in the time steps of 0.01, Okay, so first it is 0, then it is going to be equal to point plus 0.001. So now I am going to drag this so that I am going to get the value till 0.02. So it is nothing but just I am incrementing 0.01 in every step to get the t value. Now I know what is Vm. Vm is going to be 321, and I am going to drag this till here. And now I am going to formulate the formula, that is equal to sine of 2 into 3.14 multiplied by 50 multiplied by this time, and it is going to be multiplied with Vm also in the front. So the Vm is nothing but my 321, that is at this particular column, and when you give enter you will get the values, and if I am dragging I will get the complete value of the sine wave. Now I am going to plot this waveform. So how I am going to do that is by using this insert and scatter plot. So you can see it's a 321 peak sine wave with some samples like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 samples in the top and 10 samples in the bottom. So this is what my sine wave, and I'm going to make the RMS value for this. So how to do that is, which is equal to square root of, before that I'll take the square of V, and I'm going to take, which is equal to square, and I'm going to drag so that I'm getting total squared value of this samples. So this is time, this is the magnitude, and this is the sine wave equation. Now this is the V square, that is first I have squared it. Now I'm going to make the mean value. So the mean means the sum of all the values divided by the total number of elements. So the total number of elements is 22 here. That means neglecting the first column, so it is going to be 22. So we'll get the value of the mean value here. Now I'm going to take the square root. That means what I'm doing here, for every sample I am first making the square divided by the total number of value and making it into the square root. The squaring is done, dividing it by the total value is done. Now I need to take the square root. So now I'm going to take the square root. So here itself we can take the square root of, so you can see approximately 213.5 it came. Actually we need to get 230. So now we need to take the value of the Vm as 1. So this is what the square root, root means square actually. We usually use it as square root because 1 divided by square root, if you do with the peak value, you'll get the RMS, because if you put all the peak value as 1, it is a unity sine wave. Then you see I'll get 0.66 as my value. That 66, if you take it like point decimals, it will be 0.7. So 0.7 is nothing but if you take square root of 2, you need to put equal to for getting the calculation, and 1 divided by square root will give you 0.7. So it is nearly equal to the value which I have calculated. So only we usually use this 1 divided by square root of 2 for our calculations. So this is our proof, that is we get a Vm divided by square root of 2 to get Vrms. This square root comes from here. If you take more number of samples, you will get accurately 0.7. But if you take it for after 0.1 decimal, then you will be considering 0.7 only here also. So anyway, like this it is. That's it. This is how we prove that the square root is helpful for making a peak value as well as for a RMS value. Thanks for watching.